Okay, so we're going to pick up from where we left in the previous lecture. And in this lecture, I'm going to continue showing you the basics of Tails, how to see the notifications, how to edit some of the settings, connect to networks, and so on. And going back to the status bar, we have the time and the date in here. Now, if you also click on this, you'll get a nice calendar on the right. And you'll also get the notification menu in here, in which you'll see a list of system notifications. Continuing to the right, we have the onion icon right here, which shows us the status of the Tor circuit. Now, if you're not connected right now, you should see an X beside it. Don't worry about that, we'll talk about this in a minute. Besides, if you have the accessibility options, again, options to zoom in, zoom out, increase contrast, stuff that'll just make it easier to use the system. We have the language selector in here. You can change the language if you wanted to. You can click on show keyboard layouts if you wanted to add more languages. Now, going to the last icon in here, you can see the first thing we have is the volume controls. You can also see it saying wired connected. This is because I have an Ethernet cable connected to this computer. That's why I have this computer is getting internet connection. This is the easiest way to get internet connection on Tails. If you don't have an Ethernet cable, you can also connect using Wi-Fi. Now keep in mind, you'll only see this option, the Wi-Fi option, if Tails supports your Wi-Fi card or if it supports the wireless adapter that is connected to this computer. For example, it actually was not able to detect my built-in Wi-Fi card. And the only reason why I have this option here, because I have an external USB wireless adapter connected to this computer. So, if you can't see the Wi-Fi option here, it's probably because the Wi-Fi card used in your computer is not supported by Tails. I'll include a list of all Wi-Fi adapters supported by Tails in the resources of this lecture. Once you see this option, connecting to a Wi-Fi network is trivial. All you have to do is just click here, click on Select Network, select the network that you want to connect to, put the password, and you'll be able to connect. And finally, you can also see the power settings in here of this computer. At the bottom here, we have a number of icons. The first one here will take you into the preferences, so I'll just click on it quickly to show you. In here, you'll be able to change settings about the operating system, such as the background, display, privacy settings, language settings, and so on. Keep in mind, right now, our installation is not persistent, so anything you do will be lost as soon as you turn off this machine or restart it. We will talk about persistence later on in the course, so you should keep this in mind when changing settings. Going back to the top right icon, we also have the lock icon in here, which will lock this computer. Now, keep in mind, we started this session without a password. Remember, the admin password was disabled. Therefore, when you click on this, it'll actually ask you for a password to set so that you can use that password to unlock the screen again. So let's say I put a password here and then lock the screen. Now, when I come back, hit enter, and to log in now to my session, I'll have to use the password that I just set. Keep in mind, this is not an admin password. This is literally a password that we temporarily set when we lock the screen. You can also pause the current session. You can restart or shut down using these buttons. Now, the really cool thing about Tails, when you click on shutdown or when you just disconnect the USB device that contains Tails, it'll automatically shut down securely. What I mean by that is, as we mentioned before, Tails never uses the built-in storage of the computer that you run it on. It runs completely from RAM. This means that once you turn it off, it leaves no traces because RAM gets cleared every time you turn off the computer or restart it. Now, this is all good, but it actually takes a number of minutes, sometimes even up to 4 or 5 minutes, to completely clear the RAM. Therefore, if you just shut down the computer and someone grabs your computer, freezes the RAM, this RAM will still contain information about your session. And that way, they'll be able to store your RAM for a long period of time, as long as it's frozen, and then they'll be able to inspect it and get information about what you did while you were using Tails. Therefore, when you actually click on shutdown or disconnect the USB device, Tails will perform a secure shutdown in which it'll wipe the RAM before it completely shuts down. Therefore, if someone gets your computer and freezes the RAM, there will still be no information about you because Tails completely and properly cleared the RAM before it went off, before it shut down. So this is a really, really cool feature to prevent cold boot attacks.